Hi everybody, welcome once again. So I'm Yaragula Anthony here. So I'm going to teach you today the multiplication of a matrix by a scalar. So multiplication of a matrix by a scalar, that means how to multiply a number to a matrix. That's what I'm going to teach you today. And also I'm going to give you some properties of scalar multiplication of a matrix. Okay, but before that I want to thank everybody who has commented and who has subscribed the channel. So your comments and your subscription is giving me a high energy to do more and more videos to you all. Okay, so I'm very thankful for all of you who have subscribed, and I'm very thankful for all of you who have commented. Okay, so today I'm going to teach you this topic. So it will be very easy topic and very simple. So I'm going to give you two problems as an assignment, and I will be waiting that who is going to send me the first comment on the answers. Okay, so it should be you again. So all the best. So now let me teach you this part. Multiplication of a matrix by a scalar. That means if A is a matrix and K is a scalar. What is a scalar? Scalar is any number, okay, or any function it is, okay, which is a real number we can say. So then K into A is another matrix. So A is a matrix and K is a scalar, and when you multiply K with A, you are going to get a matrix KA. So KA is another matrix, and how you obtain that matrix is by multiplying each element of A by that scalar. Okay, so don't be worried about the definition. I'm going to teach you how to multiply a number to a matrix. Okay, so don't be panic. Okay, I'll give you one example and I will teach you so that you will, everybody will understand how to multiply any number to a matrix. Okay, so don't be worried about that. Now just have a look of all these properties also. Properties of a scalar multiplication. Okay, if A and B be two matrices of same order, that's what very important is, and K and L are scalars, okay, that means two real numbers we can say, then K into A plus B is equal to K into A plus K into B. That means you can multiply this K, which is a number or a real number, to both the matrix separately. Okay, then K plus L, suppose you have two numbers and you are going to multiply a matrix to that, that means K into A, K plus L into A, that you can do like this, A into K and A into L, or K into A plus K into, I'm sorry, K into A plus L into A. So these are the properties. So just have a look about them. Okay, so now I'm going to teach you how to multiply a number to a matrix. Okay, so just follow me and try to understand the method of multiplying a number to a matrix. So here is an example of multiplying a number to a matrix. Okay, so first example, if I take, if A is equals to, I will take one simple example so that everybody can easily understand what I am doing here. Okay, now suppose this is a 2 cross 3 matrix. If I want to find 2A, okay, now this is what the scalar multiplication is. I want to multiply 2 with A. So how I am going to do that? Okay, so the definition says 2 into A can be obtained. If you see the definition once again, you will understand. 2 into A can be obtained by multiplying 2 with every number here. Okay, so that's what I'm going to do now. Let me see this. 2 into 1 is 2. Okay, then 2 into 2 is 4. 2 into 3 is 6. 2 into 4 is 8. 2 into 5 is 10, 2 into 6 is 12. So that's it. So this is how you are going to multiply a number to a matrix. Now let me give you one more example so that you will become perfect in scalar multiplication. Okay. So I'm going to give you one more example. If A is equals to 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 0. And if I want to find 3A this time, okay? So are you ready? Now let us see this. What does the definition say? If you want 3A, multiply every element of A with 3. Yes? Let us do this. So 3, I'm going to multiply to all these numbers and write as it is. So I will take a matrix here now. 3 into 1 is 3. 3 into 1 is again 3. So I have finished multiplying with the first row elements. 3 into 2 is 6. 3 into 3 is 9. I have finished multiplying with the second row elements. 3 into 4 is 12. 3 into 0 is 0. Now, this is the matrix. Yes, I hope you have understood how to multiply any number to a given matrix. Okay, now with the help of this, we can add to matrices, we can subtract to matrices, even we can multiply also. Okay, anyway, multiplication I'm going to teach you in the future classes. But today, let us see, using this scalar multiplication, how to add to matrices or subtract to matrices. Okay, so let me show you that part. Example here, if A is equals to 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 1, and B is equals to 3, -1, 3, -1, 0, 2. Find 2A minus B. So this is what we are going to do now. Okay. So let us find the value of this solution. See, here we want 2A minus B. Okay. Now let us first find what is this 2A by using our previous knowledge. Yes. So 2A, how we are going to find? By multiplying 2 with every element of A. Okay, let us see how we are going to get 2A. Okay, so A is here. I am going to multiply 2 with all these elements so that I get 2A. Okay, so 2 into 1 is 2. 2 into 2 is 4. 2 into 3 is 6. 2 into 2 is 4. 2 into 3 is 6, 2 into 1 is 2. This is what 2A is. Okay, then minus B, as it is, I'm going to write here because only B it is. Okay, so B is here, 3, minus 1, 3, minus 1, 0, 2. Now this is 2A minus B. And already you are very perfect in subtracting two matrices, right? Now just do it, okay? So let us see this part. 2 minus 3, how much is it going to give us? Minus 1. 4 minus of minus 1, that means 4 plus 1, it is going to give us 5. 6 minus 3, so it is 3. 4 minus of minus 1, so it is 5. 6 minus 0, so it is 6. 2 minus 2, it is 0. Now this is our answer. So are you ready now? I'm going to give you two problems for your work and I'll be waiting that who is going to send me the first comment with the correct answers. Okay? Now here is the questions which I'm going to give you. So take them. The is the first one. If A is equals to 2, 3, 4, 2, B is equals to minus 1, 2, 3, 4, find A minus to B. This is what the question is in front of you. Now here comes the second question. Compute cos theta into cos theta sin theta minus sin theta cos theta plus sin theta into sin theta minus cos theta sin theta. So compute means they have given you a plus sign here, so according to that you should add them and say okay. Now these are the two questions in front of you, so very quickly work on that and send me the answers. Until then, be home, be at home and be safe. Okay, thank you.